down where all the frogs live. That's right, you know what? This little old boy sat down at the bottom of a big old cypress tree. On a great big knot of wood at the bottom of the tree they called the cypress knee, and you know he closed his eyes so that he could listen better to the sounds that the frogs in that pond were making. And you know, some of the frogs in that pond, when they talk, they talk like this. It would go like this. It would go. And there were a whole bunch of other frogs in that pond, too. When they talk like this. It would go like this. It would go. There were a whole bunch of other frogs in that pond, too. When they talk like this, they would go like this, they would go. I walk it out, 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 I walk it out. There was one little itty-bitty old green tree frog in that pond. And when he talked, he didn't say but one thing. Do you know what he said? He said...
Thank you. what you eat. Their toxins come from something in their diet.
Danger from attack.
She calls a quick lick taste test.
Let's see. Oh, it's definitely bitter.
Bitterness equals toxic. The reason Clark doesn't keel over from the poison is because Mantella are only mildly toxic to humans. They are brightly colored. That's to serve as a warning to potential predators to stay away.
Thank you. piece of your stomach, rib, piece of fucking human.
But it would be a fool who attempts to make a salad out of it, because all that red coloration is for a very good reason. It is poisonous, and some humans, I'm hoping I'm not one of them, actually develop allergic reactions to those frogs. Produces sticky white fluid. You just about see some of it on the top of the frog's body there. Not a lot, but that, if I was to put it in my mouth, would taste vile. And to a snake, not only would it taste disgusting, but it would also go up the snake's mouth and make it even more of an unpleasant catch.